didn't show it off the camera, but I just had a fish as soon as the sun came up. It was about a 10 pounder. A nice little, nice average size fish for here. Sun's coming up, skews are getting driven away. Hopefully, we'll get a few more. Had one during the night. It was a floating-ish fish. I didn't weigh it. It's an average size fish for here. Sun will be up shortly, as you can tell. You'll be able to see a little more. So what I'm feeding out here is all just pellets right now. I've got one industrial-sized can of cream corn here that I'm going to eat, or regular corn that I'm going to use. I am using a 15 mil pop-up as my hook bait. Just realized I forgot to put a split shot on that. It took my split shot off. The last fish did. So that would probably explain why I'm having trouble getting hook up. Sticking up in the air like that. But this other white rod here has actually got a skipjack head. And it's thrown out there to catch a blue cat. Skipjack going crazy out here. They're out here feeding on shad fry. Small menace. All that stuff is feeding on my pack bait. And some of the dust that doesn't sink down off these pellets. My pack bait is in the white bucket over here. It is a mixture of powdered molasses, cream corn, and quick oats. And I'm also putting a glug of liquid deer molasses, which is in the black jug right there. Putting that on top before I cast out. So that is my setup. I am going to hide from the mosquitoes here with my thermosel. And as soon as I sit down, I'm ready to run. That looks like a garbite. That is a big eastern softshell. Woo. If I was not attached to my fingers, I could get that hook out. But we're just gonna give this little lady a lip piercing. She's gonna wear it for a while. There's the first full catch for camera. That hook will rust out in a little over 2 weeks. I believe these hooks do. They're not saltwater hooks. They don't last a while. So she'll be all right. It was just right in the corner there. She'll be okay. And if I had a pair of pliers, I could have gotten it out. But with a turtle that big, very hard to get their neck to stick out where they can't snap at you without hurting them or cutting yourself if you don't have a glove, and I don't have a glove. So now a little disturbance is gone. It's time to get back to fishing. Alright, so for this rig, I'm going to tie a snowman with the same boilie that I'm using as my topper. The same pop-up I'm using as the topper. So I'm using a 15 mil pop up here. To an 18 mil bottom bait for the other half of the snowman rig. So I'm gonna get this on a number two hook with a micro ring swivel and floss. And then I'm going to reel that one up and figure out why the hell it's not catching fish, because that's the second time it's done that. I figured I'd show this off. I've got a lead clip here with a 4-ounce lead. All right, you're coming off. So I'm going to run my lead down there so that I can do this. Number two fang, eggs here. I want to say this is what you call a Ronnie rig. I don't know, I'm an American. This is basically just a quick link swivel with a piece of anti-tangle sleeve cut over it. Micro ring swivel in the back, dental floss to hold the baits on. Don't use your teeth. The boiling needle will be weird a couple times. I personally like to tie one knot. Then I place my bait stopper. And tie my second knot. Now it's attached. It's going to be here for a while. And I left my lighter at home, so I don't have anything to singe those to make sure they don't come out. But I will leave a little bit of tag. It says harder for them to come out. Bait will sit on the bottom just like that. Just like that. So four-ounce lead on the lead clip, because there's a lot of current here. And a 4-ounce lead, a fish is not getting away from a 4-ounce lead. There would be none of this beep 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 stuff going on behind me with a 4-ounce lead. If it goes in his mouth and that hook tries to catch, it's over. That hook even begins to pretend to hook into that fish, he's gone. All right, I fixed the balsa pack bait up around this, cast it out. This one's gonna go out farther than the rest of them. There's two reasons why I hadn't caught a fish on this one yet. Number one, I forgot to put a split shot on it. And number two, I didn't check the sides of the hook whenever I sharpened it. Got it to a decent point, but it's completely rolled off on one side. Now we're sticky sharp. I'm going to take my hair back around in the right place. Pick that up a bit there. Also, I can tell that fish picked the weight up because my stops have slid. Alright, that's on. Now, ball of pack bait, flip it back out. by that. Nice little high double. Might be scraper 20. Big, big fish, big tails. Alpha fish living in this current below this dam. That's a beautiful fish with the sun rising behind me. I'll put him back. One's a unique character. So this is a unique fish, definitely first time capture for me. Missing the eye, just completely, not even a scar from one side of his face. This first side is his normal side. This first side here is his normal side. Side. As you can see, he's got his eye there. Buddy, chill. This side here, nada. Normal. said here, nothing, just a socket. All right, I'm gonna get them back. They're still back there swirling behind me. There's the dam. I think I'm gonna call it here. I could stay and catch more fish, but my phone's almost dead. And I haven't slept at all tonight, so. To anyone watching this afterwards, because you're not watching it now, this has been morning on the Apalachicola River. Got two fish for you. I had one this morning when I was trying to figure out the stream, and I had one last night. But this has been carp fishing from one of my favorite places on earth.